Hello and welcome to Designer Spotlight. Today we are with jewelry designer August Abramaitis to talk about his brand, Jolita Jewelry, as well as showing you some of the stunning pieces that he creates. Jolita Jewelry's success has been a constant increase over the years. Their pieces have appeared in countless magazines, such as Cosmopolitan, Elle, and Black Hair, to name a few. They have also appeared in catwalk shows for designer Nomi Ansari and Ifology.
I was born originally in Lithuania, and I moved down to London about 16 years ago. I used to work on the ships, and I used to work in the QE2. We did the world cruise for about 9 months. That's why I like all the tribal jewellery, like from Nepal, China, from everywhere. I liked fashion, but I didn't know what I wanted to do with it. I started making jewellery really by accident. I had a dream, I had a repetitive dream. I was very tired because I could just see the same image of a piece of jewellery for 8 nights. So then after that, I decided to start making. That's how I started making jewellery, really. I had to learn everything myself. I did some courses later on. I didn't really like it. I knew that it wasn't for me. So then I realised I quite enjoyed working more with like mixing textiles and metal. I like clashing. I like to take something that is in fashion now and then just use something a bit different, so it's just not too predictable. Could be anything. I mean, all the braided stuff is mainly was inspired by old antique memento mori jewellery. It was in Victorian times. They usually get images or sort of ideas in my head. If I have an idea from the night before, then I'll come to work and I'll do regardless what I have to do. Well, actually, I hate making, like, repeating things. I much prefer making something new. If I have a deadline, then I will make something completely different, and then I leave everything until the very last minute. I think I work best under pressure. This, I think it took me 8 hours or more maybe, and it's not finished yet. And I don't usually do one thing in one sitting, so it takes me 3 or 4 days to finish something. Everything, silk has to be by raw silk. This is all hand dyed, has to be, yeah. In order to get these colors, and the color doesn't run, I use acid to seal. This could be done actually in one day because the color is similar. But if you go for something like this, that's definitely 2 or 3 days work, because if you mix light with dark, you can't do it in one sitting.
Do you have any favorite pieces?
Starting new collection using these ones, so it will be all. I enjoyed making it because it's a bit different from working with silk. I made a bangle years ago. It's called London Voodoo. It was all with rhinestones and skulls. I like skulls and rhinestones. That was gone to New York, so that was one of my favorite things. Everyone has their own different ideas of what they want, and I find it very difficult to understand. People have a vague idea, so then basically I'm just shooting. We have a lot of people that they come in and they have specific requests, which is okay, but as I said, that usually takes 3 or 4 times longer. You have 2 different points of reference, so by the time they join together, it takes a long time. These are all strictly just one of a kind. There's no point really repeating them. These, just because of the dyeing technique, that took a long time. Then stitching all these, because these have to be stitched. Everything is basically sewn on individually, and it has to hold, so it has to be done properly.
Can you tell us about some of your pieces?
Well, I'll show you some. These are all my new collection. They all will be one of a kind, made with rhinestones, pearls, chains, teeth, skulls, etc. That's an older one. I have another version. This is Cairo necklace. This is dip-dyed silk with rhinestones. Let's just see what colors, what works and what's not. I just put them all together, and then whatever shouts at me, then I do it. The key is knowing when to stop. Then this is Casablanca. This again, dyed lavender with sort of grey. This I experimented 2 colours, but one block on another, and it's actually dyed, keeping the dye on it overnight, so it sort of permeates but crinkled up, so you get more like splash effect. I'm just trying basically to hide it all, so all has to be done by hand. This is actually something new that I'm trying to work out, yeah. So after I finish, I'll see what it looks like, and then whether it's whether the result worth repeating, really. Thank you.
pleasure spending time with you today and learning about your brand, Jelita, and your amazing pieces. And I hope you've enjoyed having me here as well.
Yes, it was very nice to meet you.
And it was very nice to meet you too. And thank you guys for watching Designer Spotlight. It's been a great time with Jelita Jewelry today, and we hope to see you in our next episode.